Would José Feliciano please come up? I know you love the International Hall of Fame. He was born in Puerto Rico and reared on the near west side of Cleveland, and he's been a partner in the litigation group in the Cleveland office of Baker and Hostetler since 1987. Once again, see, they linger behind me, so I don't say everything. But let me just type this. I don't know Spanish. I wish I did. But I hear his son always refer to him as El Jefe. To me, that means the boss. He's the man. His son is waving the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, José Feliciano.
I got in when I got in. Look at this group over here. Lord, my gosh. So I'm going to stay consistent with the two-minute limitations I observe everyone else has got. So I consider it a high honor and a distinct privilege to be with you to celebrate this wonderful and help induct in the Cleveland Hall of Fame the Honorable Judge José Antonio Villanueva, a friend of mine for 50 years. Richard, you hear that?
Yeah.
You can't believe that he's known anybody 50 years, right? And what I'd like to do is briefly talk a little bit about his journey and talk a little bit about his career. So this occasion is indeed a special one, given the importance of what I think the Cleveland Hall of Fame really represents, and that is the most sacred of human values, liberty. My wife, Molly, and I have had the privilege of knowing Jose and his beloved wife, Peggy. And for me, she's always going to be Sweet 16, Peggy. And we've been blessed also to enjoy the friendship of his incomparable and irrepressible son, Joshua. His Honor and I grew up on the west side of Cleveland in the neighborhood of St. Patrick's Parish, where we spent countless hours playing baseball and basketball, engaging in many civic and social activities and other things too, Your Honor. And over at St. Patrick's Coffee House. I've often described the judge as a man of history, and I think describing him as such is really not an overstatement. In many ways, the journey of Judge José Villanueva is the journey of immigrant America, which is the journey of America itself. Born in the hills of Puerto Rico, initially living in projects in Youngstown when he came to America, His Honor rose to become the first Hispanic, let me repeat that, the first Hispanic in the history of this state to be elected countywide, commencing his service in 1988. You got to remember that Ohio is the seventh largest state in America. He remains to this day the only Hispanic, and let me repeat that, the only Hispanic ever elected to the General Division the common peace court of this entire state. And let me tell you a little bit about how he's done that. In 2004, Judge Villanueva received 286,468 votes. I say that again, 286,468 votes. That's a staggering number to be sure. And in 2010, he came within approximately 1,000 votes of leading every judge in the whole of Cuyahoga County. Not bad from a boy from the hills of Puerto Rico. A self-made man to be sure. And of self-made men, Frederick Douglass once said, "The idea of a self-made man is inextricably tied up with that of the American dream. It is his image that has lured thousands of immigrants to our shores, thousands. A self-made man is he who comes from unpromising circumstances, who was not born into privilege and wealth, and yet by his own efforts, by pulling himself up, by the bootstrap, manages to become the great success that he is." And that's America, too. And that's the judge personified. And that's how he's affectionately known in our community, the judge, or our judge. On the bench, he's distinguished himself with his extraordinary work ethic, consistently ranked at the top of all common pleas judges in total jury trials every year. The judge consistently receives the endorsement of the Cleveland Plain Dealer. He receives the highest ratings of the professional legal organization in Chicago County, including my own beloved Cleveland Bar Association. And to be sure, his honor has bent the arc of history in a positive direction. The judge, in my judgment, is the personification of a servant leader. I've always admired how he has stood up for the last and the least, the voiceless. Upon graduation, he immediately went into public service working for the Cleveland Legal Aid Society, serving the poor. He also served as commissioner for the Ohio Civil Rights Commission, where he championed and authored policies for the handicapped and the victims of sexual harassment. He's only one of five judges of our 33 or 38 judges who volunteered to preside over Chicago County's mental health disabilities and development disabilities caseload. On the community side, the judge's involvement and service to our community is legendary. His service includes the membership in my organization, the Hispanic Roundtable, numerous Hispanic organizations, United Way, the Greater Cleveland Roundtable, the Peter Marshall Law School. You can read all those in his bio there. Now to his heart. This was a wonderful occasion, to be sure. And I'm sure that he wishes that his beloved mother, Doña Luz, were here with us. She was the lioness of the Villanueva family. And we're blessed that Jose's sister is here from Florida, who has many of those characteristics. Loyalty, tender-hearted yet courageous, hard-working, and extraordinarily caring. Traits that were not lost on her son. Gale Sayers, the great running back for the Chicago Bears, wrote a book once entitled "I Am Third," referring to God, family, and himself. The judge's book, in my judgment, should be entitled "I Am Last," after God, family, friends, the Hispanic community, and anyone in need, and then him. I have personally observed many of his countless acts of private charity and love, and I won't tell you about it because I'll embarrass him. The scripture teaches us, blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. To be sure, Jose, God blesses you. At the same time, he had a warrior's heart on the athletic field, especially on the basketball court, like my son Dick, and on the baseball field, where he always demonstrated grace under pressure and leadership, and where he always evidenced the generosity gene. I know I was the beneficiary. He always made me look good. Let me close with one of my favorite Churchill quotes, which is particularly apropos to the judge. You make a living by what you get, but you make a life by what you give. Judge Villanueva has made an extraordinary life. I thank him. I thank God Almighty. But mostly I thank him for the treasure of his friendship. Please help me give a round of applause to my dear friend, my compadre, the judge, José Antonio Villanueva.